Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? I hope that all of you are fine and safe at home. We were discussing chapter number one and we have done. Now what is the chapter number one? That is operations onset. And we have done some topics related to chapter number one on previous days. And today we are going to continue it. Now let me first revise the topics that we have discussed earlier and then I will move ahead. Yes, what we have done in chapter 1 till now, we have done the definition of sets and how we can define the set, then we have discussed some of the examples of sets that exist in our daily life. That exist in mathematics, like we have discussed the set of natural numbers, odd numbers, even numbers, integers, and so many. Okay, then we have discussed, yesterday we have discussed subsets, that what is actually a subset, how we can define a subset, that subset, set A is a subset of set B, if every element of A, set A is present in set B. Okay, then we move to the power set, that what is a power set. Actually power set is a set of all the subsets of a set, means ki all the possible sets, subsets that are all that are combined to form a power set. Okay, then we have discussed one daily life example ki where the power set is used and how we can use in our daily life. I have given you an example of shop that has a banana chocolate and lemon ice cream. So what will be the options for a shopkeeper to have a banana chocolate and lemon ice cream? So we have make a power set of we have make the subsets of actually that options. Okay, then we move to the power set proper definition that is given in your book, that a set, if set A, if A is a set which is equals to 1 2 3, then all the sets of all the subsets of A is called the power set of A. So we have discussed this example and solved it in front of you. Then I have solved these two questions in front of you. Okay, yesterday I have given you an homework also, that you are going to solve question number 3 from exercise number 1 by yourself, right? Then we have discussed the union, the operations on sets, operations of sets. Then we have discussed the operations on sets, and we have discussed 4 operations of sets, like the union between sets, how we are going to find out the union of sets, like for example, if set A has actually union, means we are going to combine the elements of both the sets. Then we have discussed the intersection of sets, that what does intersection of set means, when set A, the common elements between set A and B are to be called as intersection of sets. Okay, then we have discussed the after intersection, we have solved some examples, and then we have discussed the difference of two sets, the set of elements that are not in, that are in A but not in B, is called the difference of set A and B. Okay, if we are going to find out the difference between A and B, so what does it mean? All the elements of set A that are not present in set B is to be called as difference of set A and B. Okay, then we have discussed these examples, and then we have done the complement of a set. Okay, I have solved one example in front of you related to complement of set. Then these were the questions from exercise, that is question number 4, 5, and 6, that you are going to do it by yourself. I hope that all of you have done all these questions. And I told you that how you are going to solve the questions on your FAIR notebooks, because all the work that you are going to do from the book is to be done on your FAIR notebooks. Clear? Like I have given you question number 3, question number 4, and question number 5, question number 6. Actually, question number 4, 5, 6 are those questions that you have done in class 7th as well. So that's why I have given you all the question in one day. ठीक है? So you have to do all these questions on your fair notebook. If you are having any problem, then you can do it first on a rough copy and then you can solve it on a fair copy. I hope that everyone has done all these things. Some of the students have sent me their homework, solved homework through WhatsApp, and I have answered you through WhatsApp that you have done it correctly. So today we are going to do question number 7. ठीक है, I will do one or two part of question number 7, and rest of the parts you have to do it by yourself. If you will have any problem, you can ask me through chat, and then I will answer you. Clear? I think it is clear to everyone. And everyone has done the homework. I think 10 to 15 students have sent me their homework, solved homework through WhatsApp, but rest of the class has not sent me. So I am waiting for the rest of the students. Now let's come to question number 7. If U is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, A is equals to 1, 2, 5, 7, and B is equals to 1, 3, 6, 7. So these are the sets. As we know, U is the universal set, one of the largest set among all the sets. A is a set and B is a set. Now first we are going to find out the A complement. As I have explained you earlier also, okay, how we are going to find out the complement. Complement means that we are going to find the difference between U and the given set. If we are going to find out A complement, it means we are finding the difference between U and A. If we are going to find out the B complement, it means we are finding the difference between U and B. If we are going to find out the difference C complement, so what does it mean? It means U difference C. U slash C or U minus C, whatever. Now let's solve this question. Now first of all, we are going to write out the elements of U, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then that minus sign or dash sign, whatever you call it, or a difference, symbol of difference, and then 1, 2, 5, 7. So when we are going to find out the difference, means all the elements of U that are not in A. All the elements of U that are not in A. ठीक है? U के वो तमाम elements जो A में मौजूद नहीं हैं. So what we will get, A complement is equals to 3, 4 and 6. 3, 4 and 6. Clear? Now, part number 2 is your homework. You are going to do it by yourself. Part number 3. A intersection B whole complement. How we are going to do it? Again, we have a complement symbol, so it means U difference definitely will be there. But U ka difference, kiske saath aapne find out karna hai? A ke saath ya B ke saath? Ya A intersection B ke saath? Theek hai? So we are actually, the symbol of complement is, symbol of complement is with this. You can notice the symbol of complement is over there. Right? We have symbol of complement over there. It means ke first we are going to solve this bracket. First we are going to find out A intersection B. First we are going to find out A intersection B. And then we will solve this operation. We will do it in this way. Clear? U minus A intersection B. So first we are going to find out A intersection B, and then we will find out the difference with its with U. ठीक है? So A intersection B means all the elements that are common between A and B. All the elements that are common between A and B, we are going to find out A intersection B. So A intersection B is equals to 1, 2, 5, 7, intersection 1, 3, 6, 7. So what we get? We get A intersection B is equals to 1, 7. A intersection B is equals to 1 and 7. Now, what we will do? What we will do? we are now finding u minus a intersection b. So u minus a intersection b, how we are going to do it? First of all, we are going to write a intersection. We are going to write the elements of u. Okay? Just look at this. U minus a intersection b. We are going to write the elements in this way. First of all, we are going to write the elements of u. And then we are going to write, when we are having a symbol of a difference, that is, this, you can call it a minus sign or a symbol of difference. And then you are going to write the elements of A intersection B. So what I have done? I have done the same thing. Okay? Here, I have done it. The elements of u are there. Okay? Then we have a sign of difference. Okay? And then we have A intersection B, the elements of A intersection B. Clear? Ab hum log kya karenge? Now what we will do, we will cancel the elements that are present in A intersection B, that is 1 and 7. Okay? So what are the elements that are left behind? So A intersection B whole complement will be 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Yes, the elements of A intersection B will be 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Clear. Achha ji, now we are going to solve one more part, that is, that could be fifth one or sixth one, any one part. Which one should I solve? Fifth or sixth? Please do tell me through chat which part I should solve. I think I should solve the fifth one. Okay. A complement union B complement. Now, first of all, we are going to find out A complement that we already have done. Then we will find B complement. And then whatever the answer we will get, like I have written it over there, A complement is 3, 4, 6 and B complement is 2, 4, 5. Now we are going to find out the union between these two complements. Okay? Union means combine all the elements of A complement and B complement. So we have got 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Is it clear to everyone? If you are having any problem, you can ask me. Is it clear? Okay, now rest of the parts, you have to do it by yourself. Now, what are the parts that are left behind? Part number 2, I think we have done it over the year. Part number 4 and 6. G, Venn diagram. What is actually a Venn diagram? Venn diagram is actually a pictorial representation of sets. Pictorial representation of sets are to be called as Venn diagram. Like this is the Venn diagram of A union B. We have drawn a Venn diagram in front of you. A union B. So A, the set element of set A is 1, 2, 3, 4 and the element of set B is equals to 2, 4, 6. Now I am going to draw a Venn diagram in front of you so that it will be more clear to you. Okay? Now I am going to draw it in front of you so that it will be more clearer. First of all, we are going to draw a rectangle. We are actually drawing a Venn diagram Okay, I am going to draw a Venn diagram in front of you, although I have drawn earlier, but I hope ki आपको ज्यादा अच्छे से समझ आ जाएगी व्हेन आई विल ड्रॉ इट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. ठीक है, सो आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ इट. दिस इज द वेन डायग्राम. वी हैव ओवरलैपिंग सेट्स. द ओवरलैपिंग सेट मींस, व्हाट डज इट मीन? एक्चुअली वेन डायग्राम इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स. व्हेनेवर वी हैव द सेट्स दैट आर ओवरलैपिंग और समटाइम्स वी आर हैविंग डिसजॉइंट सेट्स. अच्छा जी, व्हाट डज दैट ओवरलैपिंग सेट मींस एंड व्हाट डज दैट डिसजॉइंट मींस? Overlapping means whenever we have common element between the sets. Whenever we have common element between the sets, then the Venn diagram will be overlapping. And whenever there is no element, when no element between the set is common, it means ki koi bhi element common nahi hai, then we are going to draw, then these type of sets are to be called as disjoint sets. Theek hai? Then these type of sets are to be called as disjoint sets. Now, first of all, we are going to draw a rectangle. Okay? Why do we draw a rectangle? Actually, this rectangle represents your universal set. Clear? This rectangle represents your universal set. So this is actually your universal set. Okay? Over there, the universal set is not given, but still we are going to mention it. Over there. Clear? Now, how many sets are there? There are two sets, set A and set B. So we are going to draw two circles. But before drawing the circles, we are going to check whether the sets are overlapping or whether the sets are disjoint. Okay? Okay, let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2, 4, 6. So it means ke both the sets are overlapping sets. Theek hai? Because 2 and 4 are common elements between them. So the two circles that are going to be drawn should be overlapping. Clear? So I have drawn the one. I have drawn first circle and then I am going to draw the another circle also. As both the sets are overlapping. So what I have done? Should I draw it in this way? Both the circles should be separated? No. Why not? Because the sets are overlapping. The circle should also be overlapping. Clear? The circles should also be overlapping. I should unfill the circle so that it will be more clear to everyone. I should unfill it as well. Okay? Now I should... reduce the size of that rectangle as well. This clear? Now I will name it as the which set is set A. This one is set A. It should be outside the circle and this one is your set B. Okay. So I will give name to both the circles. Oh, this is your set A. Although I have drawn the Venn diagram, but still I am drawing it in front of you so that you should know ke how we have drawn it. It is clear? First of all, what we have done, we have just draw a rectangle. Okay, that rectangle is your universal set. It represents universal set. Then we have drawn two circles. One circle is representing set A. The other circle represents set B. And that central part, that is the overlapping part, that overlapping part is we are going to write the elements that are common between the two sets. In this overlapping part, what we are going to do, we are going to write the common elements. So first of all, we are going to write the common elements and then we will move ahead. Sabse pehle hum common elements ko likh lenge. So what are the common elements? 2, 4. So these are the common elements, and you can easily see that I have written them in the overlapping portion. It is clear? Now, what are the left elements? Okay. What are the elements that are left behind? Inset A, 2 is written, 4 is written. So, what are the left elements? The elements are 1, comma 3. Clear? So, these are the elements. So, we have written it down. Now, inset B, we have written 2 and 4. But we have not written 6. So, now we are going to write 6. We are going to write 6. So, what we have done? We have write down this 6 over there. Is it clear? Is it clear to everyone? And if we are going to find out A union B, we are going to find out A union B. So, what will be the elements of A union B? Definitely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is not there. 2, 4 and 6. Clear? So this will be the answer of A union B. Is it clear? So what we will do? And now the it's time to shade the Venn diagram. And shade could be according to the operation. We are finding actually A union B. So the answer of A union B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. So we are going to shade both the circles, because both the circles are having, both the circles having one these elements. So we are going to shade it. Clear? And now we are going to shade the next. Okay? So in this way, we are going to यहाँ पे हमारे पास एलिमेंट्स जो हैं ओके वी हैव डन इट इन दिस वे नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन आई थिंक दिस वेन डायग्राम इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन I have done it in this way. Now the question comes, if we have three elements, so what we will do as the third element, C, set C has five elements, but we have not overlapped C with these A and B. Why we have not done it? Because C does not have any common element. Okay? So we have drawn that set C separately. It could also have the same size, so I am going to increase its size, but actually the space is not there, so that's why I've drawn it in this way. Clear? So this is the overlapping sets also. And we are going to find out the operation, that is A intersection B, and this figure could be in this way, and we have shaded this portion. Clear? Is this clear to everyone? So today what we have done, we have actually done, I'm going to revise all the concepts. Today we have done question number 7, we have done how we are going to find out A complement, A intersection B whole complement, A union B whole complement. ठीक है, today we have done all these things and then we know how to draw a Venn diagram. Then we have drawn Venn diagram in front of you between the two sets like A union B and A intersection B. And later on we will discuss the complex Venn diagrams as well. Like difficult one, how we are going to draw the Venn diagram when there are so many elements common between them. Whenever, when we have three elements in a set, or sorry, when we have three sets, so how we are having a Venn diagram. So we will discuss the complex Venn diagram later on. Right now we have discussed only the simple one. Is it clear? If you want to ask anything regarding this point, then you can ask me through chat. Okay. So that is the Venn diagram when we are having a disjoint sets. You can easily see it. Venn diagram, disjoint sets. Okay. Set A is 1, 2, 3 and set B is 4, 6, 8. You can see easily that set A and set B both are drawn separately. Okay. Why we have drawn them separately? Because there is no common element between them. Okay. They are disjoint sets. There is no common element between them. They are disjoint sets. So we have drawn them separately. Clear? So this is the Venn diagram of disjoint set. And what we have done, we are going to find out A union B. And the answer of A union B could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. So we just shade set A and set B according to the operation. This is also one of the Venn diagram of disjoint sets. Okay, and we are finding an operation that is A intersection B. I hope it is clear to everyone. So that is, that's all we have discussed today, actually, some of the operations of set and the Venn diagram. I am not going to do something else today because it will be then more difficult for you. Okay. Now, the today's homework is you are going to solve this question. Okay. Actually, this is to be called as De Morgan's law. So what, and now your question is, you are going to solve it by yourself. Part one and part two, A union B whole complement is equals to A complement intersection B complement. This is your De Morgan's law, and A intersection B whole complement is equals to A complement union B complement. You are going to draw, you are not going to draw the Venn diagram of this these operations. You are only going to solve the De Morgan's law. Prove it, actually. You are going to prove it. And you are going to do it by yourself. You are not going to take help from anyone else. And inshallah, when we will have a class by tomorrow, so we will discuss it in the class. And if you will have, you are having any problem, you can ask me right now through chat. And if it is clear to everyone, then please say chat. Please say yes through chat. Is it clear? Is it clear to everyone? Okay. Okay, many of you have said yes. Now let's move ahead. Okay, student, I have given you today's homework as well. And the time is also over. And now I will take your attendance and then we will leave the class. Okay. Now attendance has been done. And I think no one wants to ask anything. So Allah Hafiz from my side. Okay, student, take care of your self. Stay at home. Work hard. Whatever the homework is to be given to you, do it daily basis, on daily basis. So I'll check it tomorrow that how many of you have done it or not. and then we will continue with this De Morgan's law. And then I will explain you what actually the De Morgan's law is and who was the De Morgan. And then we will continue proceed the lecture by tomorrow. Okay. So tomorrow we will solve this question in front of you. And I will need your participation as well. Okay, students. Allah Hafiz.